Today we're talking about the National Crime Statistics, which were released yesterday. Sarah, take us through some of the highs and lows. What did we find?
Murder is up. We had 650 more murders in the last year than before. Attempted murder is also up. Some of the crimes which we sometimes think are drivers of things like murder, like robbery, carjackings, trackjackings, also up. Also a spike in drug-related violence. So those are some of the more concerning figures that came out yesterday. And also, as you point out, sexual offence crimes are down. But these are crimes that are typically underreported, so it's difficult to really use that as a gauge for how the police themselves are performing.
These are apparently the worst crime figures that we've seen in the past 10 years as far as violent crime is concerned. What does this incidence of violent crime tell us about a country?
The reality is that we're still safer, much safer than we were 10 years ago. So it's not that crime's the highest levels in 10 years. It's just that for the first time in quite a long time now, most of the last decade, we've seen an increase in murder. About 60% of our murders are driven by what's called interpersonal violence. That's largely between people who know each other, who live in the same communities, who will get into an argument, often while they're drinking together, or there'll be an argument about a relationship, about money, about sports, you name it. People start insulting each other, starts becoming a violent fight, somebody gets killed. That is a bulk of our murder, and it happens in very particular locations. So about 50% of our, or 50 police stations out of 1,137 police stations record most of our murders. Some of the policing crimes, such as that, the police can impact on. They can impact on robbery because robberies are committed by a relatively small number of people. So when they go up, it means that there's a problem in the police. It means that the police are not able to utilize the resources that they have to bring those crime rates down.
Sarah, do South Africans have trust issues when it comes to the South African Police Service?
I think they do have trust issues generally when it comes to the South African Police Service. But I mean, you know, let's just draw a line between trusting the police and trusting the stats for a minute. Some researchers that we've spoken to have said, well, you know, when you talk about trust levels in the police, you need to talk about, you know, a long period in South African history when the police were not considered legitimate by their communities, and perhaps that hasn't been corrected in a lot of places. And then you look at some of the scandals that have rocked the top echelons of the police in the past few years. I would imagine that affects public confidence in the police. So there's kind of this cynicism about what they can realistically achieve, and perhaps that affects why people, you know, are hesitant to report crimes. Things like Marikana as well would have a great impact on how that community views the police and their relationship with them.
What are some of the things that the SAPS should be looking at to improve public order policing?
We, interestingly enough, have been recognized by the United Nations at one point as having some of the best public order policing strategies and training in the world. There was a huge amount of effort, money, time, and training undertaken around our public order policing from 1994, where we brought in specialized trainers from Belgium. We used international best practices as our benchmark, and we achieved those standards. And our public order policing over 10 years, we were responsible for less than about 10 deaths. Then in 2006, Jackie Selebe decided that he didn't want specialization in the South African Police Service. He wanted all police officials to be in stations on the ground fighting crime. And this is why it's so dangerous to have people who don't understand policing at the top of the organization. He wasn't willing to listen to those that are trying to say to him, listen, you do need some specialization. You've got to try and think of it like trying to make every single teacher in South Africa teach grade one Zulu and matric maths and science. You have to specialize. It's not the same thing. And that's why when you see the crime statistics being released, it is actually a big pity that it's the police minister and the police National Commissioner sitting there. It makes us think that the crime and all the violence challenge is just a policing one, when most of it is not policing, in fact. Most of our violent crime in terms of our interpersonal violence will not be reduced by policing because the police can only be there after the fact. We have a shortage of 53,000 social workers in South Africa, and we've hired 70,000 additional cops in the last 10 years. The crime stats yesterday show us that we need to change our priorities. We don't want to wait until people are violent and then send the police after them. We need to look at the factors that lead to violence, and that is, those can be addressed, and there's enough international and local evidence that shows us that how teachers behave in the classroom, how social workers are deployed, and how primary healthcare practitioners, nurses, and doctors treat patients has as much impact on violence, if not more, than police can ever have.